Welcome to the 2018 Association of Country Music in Alberta Awards, proudly presented by Stingray. Tonight, we celebrate an exceptional year of country music in Alberta, featuring performances by Aaron Goodvin, Krissy Feniak, Drew Gregory, Karac Hendriks, Lauren Mayell, Michela Sheedy, Nice Horse, Ryan Langlois, The Prairie States, Trevor Panczak, and T. Buckley. Now, ladies and gentlemen, saddle up for four-time nominees tonight. Nice Horse.
Welcome to the ACMAs, everybody!
Someone's good things again. Someone's staying out all night and rolling in 6 a.m. Just turn the light on, there's no use trying to hide it. It's getting tired, there's no use trying to fight it. Let's call a spade a spade. Doesn't change a single thing. It's how the bed was made. Every single song we sing. Just another 16. How long? Come down to steal my heart. Just another desperado trying to leave his mark. I saw it through you from the start.
Desperado. Ladies and gentlemen, Billboard magazine just called him one of the 7 artists to watch in 2019 here in Alberta. We've had our eye on him for quite some time. Your host for tonight's festivities, CCMA Songwriter of the Year, Aaron Goodvin.
Hello, everybody. How are we feeling tonight? Amazing. Welcome to the 2018 ACMA Awards presented by Stingray. Tonight, we celebrate the best of the best, the Association of Country Music in Alberta. Heck yeah. Yeah. How about Nice Horse starting us off, everybody? Nice Horse originally considered some other names for the band. I know firsthand there was the Sweet Tarts of the Rodeo, and the Frisky Chicks were up there too. But Paul Byro put an end to that right away and thought they might attract too many studs. So he recommended a more family-friendly option. I have a personal story about Nice Horse. We played a lot of shows with them, and the first time we played with them and they told me their name, I said, well, come again. And they said, well, we're Nice Horse. And I said, okay. And for the longest time, I tried to figure it out. And I just couldn't figure out why in their right mind they would call their band Nice Horse. And until last night, we were, this honest to God truth, we were driving from Edmonton to Red Deer. And My mom and dad were driving. They're here tonight, and they were driving, and my wife and I were in the back seat, and I was trying to, like, put my arm around my wife, you know, and, like, you know, try and get a little closer, and then dad would turn around. I'd pretend I was scratching my head, but I looked out the window at one point, and I seen this horse, true story, running in a field, just wind through the mane, you know what I'm saying? It was just looked beautiful. And in my mind, I went, that is a nice horse. And not 2 seconds later, in my head, I started hearing, don't need no, don't need no, don't need no mansplaining, don't need. And then I went, that is a brilliant name for a band. That is amazing. Yes, Paul, in answer to your question, I have had 4 top tens on country radio. Thank you. Very much. In less than 2 years, yes. But that doesn't count. So what was I saying? I was saying that everyone has a side hustle these days, and Nice Horse is no exception. When they're not on the road with the legends like the Nitty Gritty Dirt Band, the ladies are busy with their new business, the Dog and Pony Show pet sitting service that that I hire them for when they watch my dogs. And for a nominal fee, you can hire a Nice Horse. They will watch your dog, and they will also sing it to sleep. So if you guys are interested in that, you can get into that some of that. Yeah. So some may wonder, how the heck did I get this gig? And my mom and dad and wife are wondering the exact same thing. It all started back at the CCMAs. I was really excited to be up for Rising Star of the Year Award. And I was even more exciting. I was also a little confused because it was the second year in a row, and that's just confusing, you know? You feel like you should only get a chance to win that one once. But I was up for it twice. Maybe I'll go 3 years in a row. Who knows? I was so excited to be up for that. And more excited that the Shania Twain was the one who was going to announce all our names. So I was just super thrilled. I've been a fan of Shania forever. And then it happened. My name, my face came up on the big screen, nationally televised, and she said, Aaron Goodvin. I know. Look, Shania wasn't my first. I mean, like, my first person to mess up my name. She figured that, so I figured the only way that I could get this right and to do an award show was to just come up here and host the darn thing myself and make sure that everybody knows it's Goodvin. So here I am. It's a V, not a W. And that wasn't a shameless plug. Actually, this is a shameless plug right here, and I totally missed the joke before that. My new record is called V, by the way. So there's a lot of reasons for that. Shania is one of them. My wife's name is Victoria, And so I do have our album coming out. It's called V. We're really excited about it, February 15th. And shameless plug or segue, I'm not sure. Speaking of albums, let's talk for a second about our album of the year category. We got some gooders in here. Along for the Ride, Renegade Station. Good place to start, Drew Gregory. Lost in the Right Direction, The Prairie States. Songs for Georgia, Dan Davidson. And This Road Is Mine, Karac Hendriks. Wow, it's a beauty. A good place to start would be with my buddy and hot farm grown talent, Drew Gregory. Super talented, generally up to no good. Thank God he's a rich farmer because diapers are not cheap. And Along for the Ride, that's a great title. That sounds like something I wrote. sounds like a title I'd write. In the album of the year category, Renegade Station, as their producer Johnny Sixpack calls them, Larry, Curly, Moe, and Lady Gaga. Yeah. Speaking of being along for the ride, ACMA award winner Dan Davidson is nominated for his amazing album, Songs for Georgia, this year. In 2018, he survived 25 stops on the Brett Kissel Tour, the almost never-ending Brett Kissel Tour. The run was a barn burner. And guys, let's give Dano a big old round of applause for not only having the stamina and the ability to keep up with Brett Kissel on stage and on Instagram, but also to keep his cool when Brett's first child, Charlie, pooped on his dressing room floor. The stuff us opening acts have to deal with, right? Karac Hendriks is nominated for This Road Is Mine, while other six-year-olds in Dewberry, Alberta, were frying bugs with magnifying glasses. Karac was learning to shred on great-grandpa Chester's mandolin. Try to say that 600 times fast. That sounds like a song, by the way, like great-grandpa Chester's mandolin. I just wrote that. The first song he learned to sing and play at the same time was John Fogerty's Rock and Roll Girls. Karac's long road to this exciting nomination included a successful stint in the Gord Bamford Band and sharing the stages with the likes of Ronnie Prophet, Aaron Prochette, and Alberta's 17th premier, Rachel Rock and Roll Girl Notley. This historic performance happened down in Calgary, but it can be found all over socialist media. We want to remind everybody that tonight we are streaming. I kind of did that when the microphone failed, but we are streaming tonight. We want to say hi to everybody who's watching, listening in from all over the world. Thank you for joining us. You can hashtag ACMA2018. We know it's 2019 in Canada. It's not like we're far behind, but it's just something happened and we couldn't do the show in the year that the show is actually supposed to be in. So hello to everyone watching online. And last but not least, Lost in the Right Direction from a band that is definitely headed in the right direction, the winner of the Epic Project Wild contest, the Prairie States. Talented band. Little rough on geography, but talented band. Fantastic. We certainly could not be here without all of our sponsors, including the new presenting sponsor this year, Stingray. Thank you so much for all you do for supporting country music here in Alberta. Thank you. We've got a really, really great show planned for you tonight, you guys. Some killer performances, and we will induct not one, but two amazing gentlemen into the Alberta Country Music Hall of Fame. So let's get at it. You ready? All right. I'm a big fan of our first presenter. He's had songwriting cuts on Blake Shelton, Gord Bamford, Megan Patrick, and Blake Reed, just to name a few. He and I are both card-carrying members of the BWB&B. I know what you're wondering what that means. It means buddies with bald heads and ball caps. You know what I'm saying? That guy gets me, man. And Gord, we got your email. Gord Bamford, we got your email. We're processing your application to join. Don't worry, buddy. We'll get right back to you. Yes. And so here we go. Joining us all the way from Nashville to present Song of the Year. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Buddy Ovens. Sorry, it's Buddy Owens. Sometimes I get my W's and V's mixed up. Thank you, everybody.
Good evening, Alberta. honored to be here tonight. I'm presenting the award for Song of the Year. Song of the Year recognizes individuals who put the pen to paper and the words to music. You can't describe the feeling you get when you finish a song, and just to know it's something special, which all of these nominees are. Let's check them out.
Song of the Year. Don't Hold Back. Written by James Murdoch and Darren Gosnowski. Performed by the Dungarees. No Good. Written by Drew Gregory, Trinity Bradshaw, Brad Stella. Performed by Drew Gregory. Light and Dark. Written by Ryan Langlois and Dwayne Steele. Performed by Ryan Langlois. Mansplain, written by Brandy Sidorek, Taria Green, Katie Beaver, Jeff Dalziel, performed by Nice Horse. And Safe Harbor, written by Kent Dixon, Luane Carl, Doug Fulkins, performed by Renegade Station.
I've always wanted to do this. I've watched it my whole life, so. See if I can get it out of here. And the winner is Don't Hold Back, written by James Murdoch and Darren Gosnowski, performed by the Dungarees. Congratulations.
I didn't really expect this, so... Thanks to James, who's in Australia right now, and the Dungarees for doing such a great job with the song. Thanks to the ACMA. This is a great organization, and it's so fantastic that you all come out and support this. The more you come out and support it, the bigger it's going to grow. The more country music is going to grow, not only in Alberta, but across Canada. Thank you very much.
That's awesome. This next guy has six nominations. Count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I love this guy to death. I've written songs with him for probably about 5 years. He's a very, very good friend of mine. I love his live show, and just every year he just gets better and better and better. I could not be more proud. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the stage, my pal, Drew Gregory.
Need to look back, you can't change yesterday. Lately it's been all no good, but I know good's coming my way. La 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 la
it's okay to hurt sometimes. If you're needing that feel-good feeling, we're gonna shut out the lights tonight, we're gonna make it all right. Right here, right now, let's sing it out loud. It's time for me and you. Forget about what's getting us down and remember what's getting us through. Don't look back, don't need to look back. Can't change yesterday. Lately it's been all no good, but I know good's coming my way. Somebody who needs somebody needs a friend. Get on through it. It's how we do it. Gonna light up the band and dance. Come on, clap your hands. Right here, right now, let's sing it out loud. It's time for me and you. Forget about what's getting us down and remember what's getting us through. Don't look back, don't need to look back. Can't change yesterday. Lately it's been all no good, but I know good's coming my way. La 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 la. Coming my way.
Drew Gregory, everybody, pretty awesome. I'm very excited I got the wrong piece of paper up here. But that's okay, because we're going to have a good night, regardless of what papers I have. I'd like to introduce up here to present the next award, which I'm sure he'll tell you what it is, from Stingray, Greg Torrington, everybody.
Doesn't love surprises. I'm so pleased to be the other Greg from Stingray here tonight. We're really excited, Stingray, to be a sponsor of the ACMA event this year. With our recent acquisition of NewCap Broadcasting, with over 20 stations in Alberta, including Real Country 95.5 here in Red Deer, just declared the ACMA Radio Station of the Year yesterday. Congratulations. Stingray, as was described earlier by Greg, all these great channels on television. I do the Hot Country, Classic Country, and in the U.S., those channels in Americana, Bluegrass. We have a whole load of specialty country channels on our app. I hope you get the app. If you haven't, it's coming soon free. We got country channels featuring trucker songs, Western Swing. We have an all-Canadian, alt-country channel, a bro-country channel, 90s country, and I just wanted to announce today, I've been talking to Jackie Ray, we are going to do an ACMA channel of all Alberta artists. Yeah? 24/7. So pretty well everybody in this room is going to be on getting some broadcast time. And we are also got in the pipeline a 24/7 streaming country video channel in the works. We're ready to go when the cable companies want to pick it up, so call your local cable company. And speaking of video, here's this year's nominees.
Video of the Year. Sponsored by Stingray. Don't hold back. The Dungarees. No Good. Drew Gregory. Let's Go There. Dan Davidson. Mansplaining. Nice Horse. And Who's Gonna Love Me Tonight? Renegade Station.
ACMA Video of the Year goes to, for the song, Mansplaining Nice Horse.
Crazy. Let me stop you right there. You wanted me again, and I swear. I built this truck from the axle. So this is the first time ever I've ever been up accepting an award. The last time we did this, Krista had to go up all by herself, and she hated us forever.
And we're actually also accepting awards on behalf of Dan Davidson tonight, and so far we've only planned his acceptance speeches.
We want to say a big thank you to Lisa Mann, who did this video for us. She's absolutely incredible. So incredible, with such a strong woman, and we needed a strong woman to do a video for this song. We want to thank everyone on our team, our management, our agent, they're here tonight, and our producer, who actually wrote the song with us, too.
Yeah. You covered it.
We're done. Yeah. Woo!
Our next performer has played legendary venues such as the Commodore in Vancouver and the Bluebird Cafe in Nashville, all before the ripe age of 17. Unbelievable. She's up for Female Artist of the Year and the Horizon Youth Award. Let's welcome Krissy Feniak.
Now, to present the Album of the Year Award, welcome Alberta Country Music Royalty, Dwayne Steele.
Well, the process of putting an album together is one of the most exciting times in an artist's career. From writing and choosing the songs to seeing them come to life in the studio, it's a chance for an artist to make a statement with the collective work. Now let's take a look at this year's Album of the Year nominees.
Album of the Year, sponsored by Seroma Entertainment, Along for the Ride, Renegade Station, Good Place to Start, Drew Gregory,
lost in the right direction. The Prairie States. Songs for Georgia, Dan Davidson. And This Road Is Mine, Karac Hendriks.
And the winner is... Songs for Georgia, Dan Davidson. Dan is not here tonight, so the lovely ladies from Nice Horse will accept.
All right, this is the speech we prepared.
We're going to be really good at this one, we promise.
It starts feeling pretty good.
First of all, we know that Dan wishes he could be here with everyone tonight. He told us that earlier today, and he wants to thank Jeff Dalziel, who's been such a big supporter and such a great producer and ally for him for this record and for all of his previous works.
And he'd probably want to thank Bill Miller. He'd definitely want to thank Jen, his wife,
absolutely,
and his kids, Juliet, yep, and Georgia.
Absolutely. And I think probably most of all, he would probably want to thank his band, Nice Horse, right?
That's true. We are a little bit on that record.
His real band he would love to thank.
All right, I think, is that it?
We're done.
Awesome. She is a beloved figure, not only in the Alberta country music scene, but nationwide, as she was recently inducted into the CCMA Hall of Fame. And I could personally tell you that the after party was something to see. It really was. I remember I played for this lady while she was, I wouldn't say, like, drunk, but definitely under the influence of something, which will make no sense when I introduce you. Please welcome from 840 CFCW, Alberta's country legend, one of my favorite on-air personalities ever, ACMA Hall of Famer, Jackie Ray Greening.
Boom, boom, boom. You make me go boom, boom, boom. Hello. So I started stripping. Oh, wrong speech. Shoot. No. You know, I do not say this lightly. Bev Munro made CFCW the country powerhouse it is today. Bar none. Back in the 60s, 70s, 80s, you'd find him not only doing the morning show, but he would also be hitting the road and doing a gig with his band, The Babysitters. And let's just say some of the late night drives back to Camrose were really interesting. He was born and raised in Manitoba. Bev's first radio gig was in Brandon in the 50s. When CFCW became Canada's first country station in 1960, so many people thought the powers that be at CFCW were nuts, because back in those days, radio stations played a little bit of everything. And for a station to do nothing but country music, they thought, how stupid. They called them hillbillies, but they became rich hillbillies. Looking for credibility with the country crowd, the big cheese doodles at CFCW offered Bev Munro a job. He had been named Country DJ USA by WSM in Nashville a few years earlier. And many of you may not know that Bev was signed to Capitol Records in the 60s, so is a country singer as well. So that gave CFCW the big credibility they needed. So he was hired in 1963 and would remain at CFCW until his retirement 30 years later. For me personally, I grew up listening to Bev, and the house would be absolutely quiet when the knee slapper came on. No one could tell a joke like Bev. He had this little giggle that was infectious. What was the knee slapper? Give this a listen. We're going to roll some audio here, Bill. If not, Jackie Ray will have to tell a joke.
Ladies and gentlemen, CFCW presents Bev Munro and your morning knee slapper.
Here's one.
that Jackie Ray I know will frown on. But it's too bad. After I do it, who cares? The guy went with a gal. She said to him, "My goodness, you have a small organ." He said, "Yeah, I didn't know it had to play in a cathedral."
Country favorites of yesterday and today. 790 CFCW.
Oh, yeah. Yes, it was wonderful. Even after Bev's retirement, we'd use him from time to time on classic vignettes. More knee slappers he did for us. Or there was a time our morning team read lyrics to a Taylor Swift song. Take it away, Bev.
And now, legendary CFCW morning man Bev Munro reads lyrics to Taylor Swift songs.
I remember when we broke up the first time saying, "This is it, I've had enough." It's like we hadn't seen each other in a month. When you said you needed space, what? Then you come around again and say, "Baby, I miss you, and I swear I'm gonna change, trust me." Remember how that lasted for a day? I say, "I hate you." We break up. You call me, "I love you." Oh, we called it off again last night. But ooh, this time I'm telling you, I'm telling you. We are never, ever, ever getting back together. We are never, ever, ever getting back together. You go talk to your friends, talk to my friends, talk to me. But we are never, ever, ever getting back together. End of story. That's it.
CFCW.
Isn't that awesome? Oh, my goodness. I tell you what, we lost a member of the family when he passed away last year on April 4th. He was 89 years old. What I loved is he performed with his beloved Canadian country music legends right up till a couple of minutes before he passed away. A DJ, a singer, a songwriter, a husband, quite a few times. A father, entertainer extraordinaire. I so love Bev. Everyone at CFCW did, and the listeners still tell Bev knee slapper jokes. Would you please help me in welcoming his son, Darcy Munro, to the stage as we induct Bev Munro posthumously into the Association of Country Music in Alberta's Hall of Fame. Darcy?
Well, let's see if we can do Dad proud with this one. A lady asks her husband to go out and get a turkey for Christmas dinner. And he looks at her and he says, "Honey, it's Christmas Eve. Where the heck am I going to find a turkey at this time?" She says, "Well, go try the local butcher." So he heads into town, goes into the shop. The guy says, "Look, man, I'm sorry, we're all sold out. But I tell you what, I got some live chickens out back. You're welcome to have one of them." So he thinks, "What the heck, I got to bring something back." So on his way home, he happens to pass by the local movie theater. And this guy is the biggest John Wayne fan you've ever seen. And what should happen to be playing? True Grit. So he looks around. He takes that live chicken, stuffs it down the front of his pants, buys his ticket, and in he goes. Well, a couple minutes into the movie, that chicken starts to stirring. And he thinks to himself, "Oh my gosh, it's suffocating." So he leans back, unzips, pulls the chicken's head out. Well, there's a couple of elderly ladies sitting beside him. And the one leans over to her friend and she says, "Edna, hey Edna, this guy beside me is exposing himself." And her friend says, "Ah, heck, you've seen one, you've seen them all." She says, "I know, but this one's eating my popcorn." Ah, yes, that's the Bev Munro knee slappers I remember. Perhaps for the rest, looking back isn't best. But for me, it's a way to survive. That was one of Dad's favorite Ray Price songs. And ever since he passed away in April of last year, perhaps no truer words have been spoken. But our family is very honored to be here to accept this award in Dad's name. He loved being on the air, and he lived to entertain. Dad was a big man, but he never looked down on anybody. He just simply looked him in the eye and spoke the truth. He loved his fans. He adored his listeners. He respected the industry, and he had an unmatched passion for traditional country music. Now, Dad always knew that the country music industry would continue to grow, and with it, that country music might change, but he never forgot his roots. I know I'm receiving this award posthumously, but believe me when I tell you that Bev Munro is still with us. I see it in the perfectionism of the singers and the musicians in this room. And I hear the inflection in the voices of the on-air personalities. And that's a good thing. That's part of the reason we teamed up with CFCW to form the CFCW Bev Munro Scholarship Award for the broadcasting program at NAIT, so that others could follow in Dad's footsteps. Thank you. And now, seeing Dad's name up there with the best of the best in Alberta country music, you can bet that old Tall in the Saddle is smiling down on us tonight. And he's very humbled and mighty proud. So we would truly like to thank the ACMA for honoring Dad with this induction, and to thank all of you for keeping Dad here and in here, and for never forgetting your roots. Thank you very much.
Now, let's get back to the stage for another Rising Star nominee performance. Joining us tonight from Lethbridge, Alberta, Trevor Panczak.
A little path through the trees, a little shade down by the river. A little cane pole, no bites, take a nap. That's where I go to come back. A little Friday night lights and an ice cold Coca-Cola. A little good old boy slap on the back. That's where I go. Back from the world that's turning crazy, back from the roar of the radio news, back down to earth, the roots that raised me right to the things worth holding on to, back to the air, worth me breathing, back to the place where I can see reality, back to being me. Little concrete block church, a lot of out of tune singing, and a few good words from a man in black. They got a little garden of stone, full of weeds and wildflowers, and some people I've loved from my past. That's where I go to come back from the world that's turned. Back from the roar of the radio news, back down to earth, the roots that raised me right to the things worth holding on to, back to the air, worth me breathing, back to the place where I can see reality, back to being me. Little red brick house, breeze blowing through the curtains, a little county road dot on the map. that's where I go. That's where I go to come back. That's where I go. Thank you very much. Hello, Hudson.
Trevor Panczak, everybody. Guy's really tall. It's always weird for me when there's like really tall people around. It kind of freaks me out. But I really like Trevor. He's a really nice guy. Anyway, he's one of those guys who's always out there on the road, has a busy touring schedule. 2018. He spent some time out on the road on several Brett Kissel shows. Do you guys know Brett Kissel?
Cool.
Brett couldn't be here tonight. He and Cecilia are expecting their third child in what seems like 3 years. So let's give him a round of applause for that. Proving that center ice at Rogers Place is the only time his mic didn't work. I've been waiting a month to say that. Brett and Cecilia are pretty pumped about their growing family and look forward to one day setting up their own merch farm outside of St. Paul, where the girls can hum daddy's songs while sewing T-shirts and making cool guy scarves for Becky to sell at the shows. So, I'm going to buy one. One more Kissel, baby, and Auntie Jackie Ray will have a curling team to coach in her radio retirement. It's fantastic. I wish I had more Brett Kissel jokes, mostly because he's not here, and he might be watching. Hey, buddy. And now to present Male Artist of the Year, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome from Port Swing Entertainment, Lori Brown.
Hello, everybody. All right. This category is bursting at the seams with such strong talent, so much so that we have 6 men in the running for Male Artist of the Year this year. Take a look at the nominees.
Male Artist of the Year, sponsored by Port Swing Entertainment. Brad Saunders. Dan Davidson. Drew Gregory. Karac Hendriks. Ryan Langlois. And Trevor Panczak.
Dan Davidson. I think we're going to see the nice horse ladies again.
Hello. Randy told me I had to talk this time. So I only planned the one speech, which was to thank Jen and thank Juliet and thank Georgia and thank Bill Miller, thank Louis O'Reilly, and us. Oh, and Jeff.
And his band.
And his band. And his whole team.
And we've been texting with him this whole time, yes. And he's sitting in bed in the Dominican right now, just watching and following along. So I know he's really excited to have this award. So thanks to all of you.
I thought I was doing the talking.
Oops.
He says thank you.
I get to do this now. This is exciting. This last year, the band and I were lucky enough to tour across Canada playing our hits to thousands, but I can't tell you, no one in the band was happier about wrapping up 2018 than not having to play Lonely Drum again than my keyboardist, Mr. Rob Shapiro. Sorry, Rob, but Lonely stand-up keyboard just doesn't have the same sizzle to it. So we as artists could not do what we do without the musicians who play on the albums and play in our bands on the road. Their dedication to their craft is truly inspiring. Let's hand out some hardware to one of these deserving nominees right now.
Musician of the Year. Johnny Gasparic. Josh Rizicki. Lisa Dodd. Mitch J. And Weston Blatts.
And the award goes to Mitch J.
Perfect height for me. I had a note in my phone, like a reminder telling me to maybe prepare something to say because I might have to do this, and I kept ignoring it for the last few days. But this is really cool, and I count myself fortunate to get to play with a lot of wonderful artists who reside here in this province. And it's great being up on stage with any of you that I've had the pleasure of sharing the stage with, and hope to do it lots more. Thanks a lot.
Hey, take this. Yeah. Okay. Just about left without his award, too. Our next performer is known for her high energy shows and her warm smile. She's up for two awards tonight, including Female Artist of the Year. This girl's making waves. Let's give it up, performing her new single, Rules Need Rebels. Give it up for Lauren Mayell.
No rock without storm, with no love without hate.
Last night at the kickoff party, our industry awards were handed out. Congratulations to the Calgary Stampede winner of Talent Buyer of the Year Award. Please welcome Natasha Mandruziak from the Calgary Stampede to present the award for Group or Duo of the Year.
What a pool of talent in this category. All of these groups have had an incredible year and show no signs of slowing down. Let's find out who the nominees are.
Group Duel of the Year, sponsored by the Calgary Stampede, Nice Horse, Renegade Station, the Dungarees, The Orchard, and the Prairie States.
And the winner is Nice Horse.
My band thought it would be funny if they made me talk again. we'd really like to thank our manager, Rob Lanny, who's here. Thanks, B. I think they just wanted to see me lean over. Our agent, Paul Byro, our producer, Jeff Delzeal, everybody who's helped us this year. It has been kind of a whirlwind year for us. So
there are a lot of people in this room who have helped us, because we've only been a band for 3 years, and there are so many people I can see and I've seen in this room that have helped us along the way.
And our families, they put up with a lot of bullshit.
Thanks for letting me hang out with you, girl. It's been all right.
Thank you so much.
Sorry, I was making contacts. A little late. Please welcome another award winner from last evening's festivities, winner of Industry Music Person of the Year. Sure, why not? From Alberta Music, Cindy Klassen. Carly Klassen.
Always forget my little step stool moments like this, but that's okay. I'm very happy to be here, and Alberta Music is happy to once again partner with the ACMAs. It's a wonderful weekend to bring the country music community together, and it's wonderful. It's like a little family reunion. It's really great. I'm very pleased to be here today to introduce Alberta Music's special guest performance tonight. Hailing from Calgary, Alberta, he's just released his fifth studio album, which has had tremendous success. He reached top 20 on the CBC radio charts, recently voted in as a favorite artist on the CBC top 20, is T. Buckley.
Thank you.
didn't seem as fun anymore. I still remember a long dark hair, the look in her soft brown eyes. I thought something was wrong for the longest time. I just couldn't get her off of my mind. Daddy must have thought I was crazy. Mama thought that I was losing my mind. Nothing really matters in this whole wide world. You're lost in love for the very first time. And I remember the first day of school. Yeah, she came walking through that classroom door. Felt like a newborn colt trying to find my legs. Crashing to the floor, I tried to make a little conversation, but I couldn't think of what to say. Well, she looked at me so sympathetically, I didn't know what it was. Swept away, and I guess she probably thought I was crazy. Teacher thought that I was losing my mind. Nothing really matters in this whole wide world. You're lost in love for the very first time. I was out of nowhere, just what was in store for. It's all a distant memory. Oh, but I still smile when I think of her and all of the things that she made me see. And I know that I was totally crazy, and I had definitely lost my mind. But nothing really matters in this whole wide world when you're lost in love for the very first time. You're lost in love for the very first time.
Please welcome Michelle Alexander from Ranchman's Cookhouse and Dancehall to present the Rising Star of the Year Award.
Hi, everybody. How we doing? I'm very proud to be able to present this award. The Rising Star of the Year Award is highly coveted in the Association of Country Music in Alberta. These artists are all on the cusp of breaking nationally. Previous winners include the Dungarees, Dan Davidson, and Brett Kissel, to name a few. Our nominees tonight are...
Rising Star. Sponsored by Ranchman's. Karac Hendriks. Lauren Mayell. Nice Horse. The Prairie States. And Trevor Panczak.
If I can get it out of here. The Prairie States.
Wow. We brought Doc with us. Yeah. There he is. Doc's on a plane right now with the dungarees coming home. We loaned him out. So last year, Matt and I, on a last minute, bought two tickets. We sat in the very back of this room. We didn't know anybody. And here we are today. Wow. We want to thank the ACMAs. The Edmonton Arts Council gave us a grant to make that first record. Our girlfriends and wives and families. Producer Jay Sparrow, engineer Brad Smith. Project Wild for changing our life. Yes. Alberta Music, Wild 95, Jim Pattison, Canadian Radio, and all of you. Thank you for welcoming us into your community. This means so much to all of us. Good? Yeah, great. Thank you.
Hey guys, Tennille Towns here. Welcome to the 2019 ACMAs. I so wish I could be there in person with all of you tonight in Red Deer, but I'm sending my biggest hug to all of you and a congratulations to all of the nominees and winners. Just so proud of you guys. What a wonderful night to celebrate. I'm cheering from here. Want to say thank you to our sponsor, Stingray. You guys are wonderful. And now it is my great honor to get to introduce you to this next performer. This guy, way back in the day, helped me put together my very first band show. We rehearsed at his place. I just absolutely adore him. And he's had some very exciting things going on in the last little while. He was just named one of Billboard magazine's top 7 artists to watch in 2019. His latest single, You Are, such a jam, from the brand new record that is available everywhere on February 15th. So soon, so exciting. Performing that track, which is also his 4th consecutive top 10 hit. So cool. And I got to watch this guy get up at CCMAs and win Songwriter of the Year. That is just amazing. Congratulations. Please give it up for your host tonight, Aaron Goodvin.
I'm a real black and white. I'm a half glass empty, negative cider, I'm a jerk. When I'm mad, I'm good at running my mouth, but I don't like to brag about that. Ha! But about that, I ain't worth it. Lord knows I ain't perfect, but you are the best decision that I ever made. You are everything to everything I am. You're 1 in 7 billion. Girl, I've been near and far. Ain't nobody like who you are. And I love who you are, cause you know who you are. Can't believe that you're mine, all mine. But you are, yeah. Sometimes I wonder why you put up with me. I'm in over my head, girl, I'm out of my league. I'm hell on you, girl. If I could, I'd tell the whole world. You are the best decision that I ever made. You are everything to everything I am. You're 1 in 7 billion. Girl, I've been near and far. Ain't nobody like who you are. And I love who you are, cause you know who you are. Can't believe that you're mine, all mine. But you are. You are the best decision that I ever made. You are everything to everything I need. You're 1 in 7 billion. Girl, I've been near and far. Ain't nobody like who you are. And I love who you are, cause you know who you are. Can't believe that you're mine, all mine. But you are. Can't believe that you're mine. But you are, yeah, you are, yeah, you are, can't believe that you're mine, all mine, but you are. Get him up, get him up, get him up.
Thank you very much.
And now, to present the Horizon Youth Award, welcome Irma McPherson from IMAC Management.
Oh, thank you. And Aaron, awesome. I'm so happy for you. I'm so proud to be presenting this award tonight. So as an association, we believe in fostering the next generation. Our youth members have been showcased all weekend, along with various performances and opportunities. And I am so proud, because I get very emotional about it. But I want to say, I'm so proud to present this Horizon Youth Award today. Here are the nominees.
Horizon Youth Award. Sponsored by IMAC Management. Haley Benedict. Hannah Gazzo. Jonah Langlois. Krissy Feniak. And Martina Dodd.
And the award goes to Krissy Feniak. Yay!
Wow, this is crazy. Holy cow. Oh my goodness. First of all, I want to thank the ACMA and Marianne Gibson. She believed in me before anybody else did. And of course, my parents, they're so supportive. They're so great. Yes. And I'm sorry about the visa bill. That's probably mostly my fault. I want to thank Tamara Beattie. She's there for me no matter what, whether it's for my career, for my voice, or whether it's a personal thing, she's always there for me, and I love you like a sister, Tamara. I also want to thank Maddie McKay. He's more than a producer. He kicks my butt when I need it, and sometimes I need it, and he's always there to kick the other people's butts that are mean to me, so thank you so much.
Please welcome back ACMA Hall of Fame member, Jackie Ray Greening.
All right. Yes, two CFCW alumni get to go in tonight. And Prairie States, congratulations. And they did a station visit this week to CFCW, and we have a station mascot dog that took a dump while they were performing, and they carried... Right on. You are pros. You're true pros, Prairie States. True story. Well, first it was Bev Munro, and now it is Mr. Larry Donohue that is going into the Hall of Fame. Now, Larry and I worked together for 30 years. And for those of you that have been to our West Edmonton Mall studios, Larry's office right next to mine. And instead of getting off our big butts through the years, we just yell at each other through the wall. And since his retirement last month, I've been yelling and no one's answering. But I tell you what, I'm so very, very thrilled for him because he's put so much into this industry. He was born and raised in St. Catharines, Ontario. He got his first radio gig working the overnight shift in his hometown. That was 1970. 5 years later, he makes the move out west with his wife, Beth, to Chilliwack, and they worked in radio until they started having a family and figured that he better get a job that paid. So he sold insurance for a little bit, but that didn't last long. He had to get back into radio. So if you can envision this, it's 1984. Larry goes for an interview in Camrose, and Warren Holt was our general manager at the time. And at the end of the interview, all Warren did was threw the Camrose booster at him, the local paper, and said, okay, you have 60 seconds, do a remote cut-in. Larry was hired on the spot. So he had every job at CFCW. He worked morning radio, he did evenings, he did weekends. Within 5 years of his arrival, he was named the music director. So he did that for the next 25 years. Things that you might not know about Larry, he once had hair. In fact, he was a drummer in a rock band. Traveling Mabels, you here? Yes, Traveling Mabels will remember Larry. We were at a Royalty Records party at Canadian Country Music Week, and we got up on stage. I sang Delta Dawn, and Larry was my drummer. Yeah, thank God there was no social media in those days, or else I would not be in any Hall of Fame, I can tell you. But Larry was on the drums. He loves red wine. He loves to cook. And we sure miss him around the station. You know, it's not easy being the music director of CFCW, the ballsy sound of AM radio. We are Canada's first country station. We have to be true to the brand that is Alberta's country legend. We have to be different from the FM stations to survive, and that's why CFCW is still surviving. We'll turn 65 this year, and it's because of Larry's ear. Thank you. Yep. You know, and the other thing, our focus, we were talking with Harlan Smith at our table, the other big focus always has been supporting local talent. CFCW has always done that, and Larry's been a big driver behind it. And I'd like to ask Gord Bamford to come up on stage and join me to say a few words, because Gord totally gets how Larry supported our acts over the air. Bam Bam, come on up. He's inviting me for a drink. He's saying I should stay the night. This could be a really bad night.
I actually paid for a hotel room for you, Jackie. So, you know. I'm here representing so many Canadian artists that Larry Donohue has helped over the years. Whenever I paid a visit to CFCW, Larry was always so positive and encouraging. He was also one of the first music directors to add my first single, 24 by 24, back in 2002. That's making me pretty old, but I'm lucky enough that Larry has added every one of my songs since, and I think JR might have something to do with that too, so thank you. I understand now that AJ Keller is a new music director at CFCW. Congrats. Come on up here, buddy. Let me see if I can put you in a headlock. No, seriously, AJ Keller is here to accept on Larry's behalf. Unfortunately, Larry couldn't make it tonight. But would everybody please help me welcome the latest inductee into the Alberta Country Music Hall of Fame, one of the greatest, a guy that worked almost 50 years in radio, the last 35 years at the legendary CFCW. Please stand up and raise your glass in the air to Larry Donohue.
All right, thank you. Larry. Where the heck is Larry Donohue anyways? Well, he retired on December 21st, and that was the Friday right before Christmas, December 22nd, and he was getting into social media. I mean, the last few years, he was really getting into it, but December 22nd, I went to see if he was still on Facebook. He's gone. Twitter, gone. He's nowhere to be found on social media. So we got a hold of his new email address, which I can't give to anybody else. Mm-mm. And we were emailing back and forth. We said, Larry, you're getting inducted into the Hall of Fame. He's very excited. He sent a little scripture I'm going to read in just a second. But we said, can you come? He said, no, I can't make it. We said, well, with technology, we're live streaming the thing. Maybe we can send a camera to you and we can live stream your acceptance speech. But he said, no, I'm having a colonoscopy. So we said, no, we don't want to do that. And that's the truth. That's actually happening, right? That is actually happening. And for the last half an hour, we've been Googling colonoscopy over here. So if you want to zoom in and just look at some of the pictures here. No, I'm just honored, and it's a dream come true to follow Larry up. He was so big in my life in the last 7 years, teaching me so much about the music side of the business and being a broadcaster overall. So it is just a dream come true to be CFCW's next music director. But this is what Larry sent, okay? I'm AJ Keller. Larry has asked me to read this. Okay, yeah, okay. I'm sorry I can't be there with you. Oh, my phone died. Sorry I can't be there with you all tonight. I'm humbled by this honor. 35 years ago, some of you old dogs, and you know who you are, welcomed me into the country music world. You taught me an appreciation for this great genre of music. Over the years, it's been a pleasure to watch the younger ones grow and become the great artists they have become. I am grateful to have been a part of this Alberta Association from day one. I fondly remember those early coffee shop meetings and planning the first awards night. It's time to turn over the reins to the next generation. Don't go easy on the young fella, AJ Keller. You never went easy on me. Thank you so much for this wonderful honor. God bless you all. Have a good night. Larry Donohue, everybody. Thank you.
AJ Keller. Hey, AJ, if you're listening, my song You Are is in the top 10, and now that you're a program director, we need to have a chat later. CFCW. All right, I'll come say hi. More spins. Get ready to be wowed. Get ready to be wowed by this next group, a band birthed from sweat, soul, and seasons. They took home the grand prize, the Project Wild Artist Development Program, down in Calgary in November. Yes, they did. And they are also your Rising Star Award winners tonight. Please welcome the Prairie States.
Hello, everyone. We're the Prairie States.
right direction. No need for reflections. Lost in the right direction. No need for reflections.
On behalf of the ACMA, we do want to thank Alberta Radio for all that they do, including the major support of this association and this award show. A big congratulations goes out to Real Country 95.5 from right here in Red Deer, who won Radio Station of the Year last night. Let's give them a round of applause. And to introduce you to one of my favorite people in radio, love this girl to death, director, program director for 95.5. Give it up for Jen Dalen, everybody.
I was very honored to be asked to present this next award. 2018 was a big year for not only Canadian country music females, but Alberta country music females. Terry Clark, inducted in the CCMA Hall of Fame. Lindsay L., a previous recipient of this award, first number one in a decade with Criminal. The previous number one from a female was by Terry Clark, by the way. And then our good friend Tennille Towns, also a previous recipient of this award. Well, she toured with Miranda Lambert, Little Big Town, on tour right now with Dierks Bentley, and last night went number one with Somebody's Daughter. By the way, that is the, if I'm correct here, this is the first number one from a debut from a major label since Carolyn Dawn Johnson and Georgia. So let's take a look at the Female Artist of the Year nominees.
Female Artist of the Year. Ali. Andrea Nixon. Krissy Feniak. Lauren Mayell. And Michela Sheedy.
Artist of the Year ACMA Award goes to Lauren Mayell.
I just want to thank everyone in this category, all you wonderful women. We go this year. This is our year, and we're killing it. And thank you so much to the ACMAs for having me tonight and being able to perform and for this award. I've worked really hard in the past couple years, and it's amazing to have this payoff and this recognition. So thank you so much. I have to thank my wonderful team because I cannot do this without any of them. My band over there, they are the most amazing guys in the world. Thank you. To my father, Larry, thank you so much for believing in me. And being here all the way through to this journey. And to my grandfather, Charlie Mayell, thank you for the inspiration. And to my team, Jeff Johnson, Tracy Singer, Rob Hattie. I literally cannot do any of this with my whole entire team. So thank you so much. You guys have a great night.
From Big Valley Jamboree, please welcome Chris Melnichak to present the Entertainer of the Year Award.
Thank you. As Big Valley Jamboree, it's really special for us to present the Entertainer of the Year Award, especially since this year all the nominees have actually graced our stages, so it's really nice to see. The Entertainer of the Year category recognizes those Alberta artists who have paved the way for our members. We are grateful for their contributions to our industry as a whole, as they continue to inspire our future stars. Here are our nominees.
Entertainer of the Year, sponsored by the Big Valley Jamboree. Aaron Goodvin. Brett Kissel. Gord Bamford. Lindsay L. And Paul Brandt.
All right. And the winner is... Well, we could take this and give it to him at Big Valley Jamboree, or Aaron Goodvin can come get it right now.
I ain't worth it. Lord knows I ain't perfect. But you are the best decision that I ever made. You are everything to everything I ain't. You're 1 in 7 billion. Girl, I've been near and far. Ain't nobody.
Well, now I know why you asked me to host. I'm totally kidding. When I was 12 years old, my mom, I played hockey, and I had a really bad temper, and I was very ADHD, and my mom looked for something that I could focus my time and energy on, and what we found out that we could do is I could enter in a karaoke contest in the Grand Prairie Mall, and I sang Be My Baby Tonight, because every 12-year-old loved that song. Would you wanna be my baby tonight? And something happened that day that has changed my life, and I went through a lot of really, really, really hard times in my 20s, and meaning I just drank a lot, and I don't drink anymore, so I'm really proud of that also. But but I made it through all that, and this is incredible. Like, entertaining to me is I am more comfortable up behind this microphone than I am comfortable doing anything else. And I'm so happy that I have a family that understood that. I now have a wife who really understands that, and that's a really darn good thing. There's not a day that wakes up that I don't go, God, I can't believe I married you. And I'm so happy about that. She's here tonight. So this is really incredible. I want to say that, like, to me, entertaining is taking people through a journey and letting them see who you are, even though that's so friggin' hard to do sometimes. And for me, when I play live, it's all about the music. I want every song that I play, I want that song to kick you right between the teeth. And we just try to do that night in, night out. I have to thank my band, Casey, Mike, Matt, Rob Shapiro, who's here tonight, our sound guy, Jeff, who makes sure we sound good out on the road. My management in Nashville, Grassroots, Nancy Tunick, Mandy West, Jim Alderdice, everybody there. And then more importantly, I also want to thank all the other guys in this category. Paul Brandt is like one of my biggest. I grew up watching him. I got to tour with Gord Bamford. Brett Kissel, I got to make fun of him tonight. And that is so much fun for me. And I love him to death. I've known him since he was 12 years old, so I'm allowed to make fun of him. He's an incredible entertainer. I'm really surprised that I won this here tonight. This is, like, truly amazing. And I will do my damnedest to get one of these in America because we're about to embark on that. And a big, big thank you and a big reason for that is my agent, Mr. Paul Biro, who we've gone through a lot of ups and downs over the years. And he stuck with me and believed in me, and I cannot wait to see what we can do in 2019. Thank you all so much. This is incredible. I will never, ever forget that my first Entertainer of the Year was at the Alberta Country Music Awards, where it damn well should be. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Our next performer has had an outstanding year, including a $75,000 win in Project Wild Artist Development Program. Please welcome Male Artist of the Year nominee, Ryan Langlois.
Sunday mornings and Saturday nights, sinners and saints, best of intentions and wicked ways, light and dark, ain't that far apart. Truth and lies, right and wrong, black and white, lovers and friends, hitting the jackpot and losing a game, light and dark, ain't that far apart, light and dark. Ain't that far apart? I've been a victor and a loser, stone cold sober and a user. I've rejoiced in love and mourned a broken heart. On this long road I have seen enough that I've come to believe that the space is in between light and dark. Ain't that far apart? Light and dark. Ain't that far? Lost and found, begging for change and wearing a crown, flesh and blood. We're all made of the same stuff, light and dark. Ain't that far apart? Light and dark. Ain't that far, far? I've been a victim.
stone cold sober, any user, I've rejoiced in love and mourned a broken heart. On this long road I have seen enough that I've come to believe that the space is in between light and dark. Ain't that far apart? Light and dark, ain't that far apart?
Wow, that was fantastic. Big hand for Ryan Langlois, everybody. That was great. Now to present Fans Choice Award, please welcome from Cook County Saloon, Alex Gaudet.
Damn, he's short. No country artist music. Country artists treat their fans like gold. And it's one of the things that sets us apart. We all know that there are no other fans like country music fans. And for that mutual love, we celebrate the Fans Choice Award category.
Fans Choice, sponsored by the Cook County Saloon, Dan Davidson, Drew Gregory, Haley Benedict, Megan Dawson, the Prairie States, and Renegade Station.
And the winner is the Prairie States.
Obviously, this is chosen by the fans, and so it means a lot to us that, our fans have been super supportive from day one. They come out in droves. They come, you know, cheering, screaming, stomping, shaking, and especially in Matt's hometown of Wabasca de Maris, they have been super supportive. The charity event that was thrown out there last year, they came out and, you know, donated and mass amounts and really helped out some amazing causes. So to the fans of the Prairie States, thank you so much again. To our girlfriends, wives, families, thank you so much. Again, to the Edmonton Arts Council, without them, this record would never have been made, and we wouldn't have had something to sell to our fans at shows. So to the Edmonton Arts Council, thanks. And to Big Valley Jamboree, who are giving us a big shot here in the summer. They're always super supportive of emerging artists and give a monstrous platform to people getting going and getting rolling. So to Big Valley Jamboree, Mike, Chris, thank you so much. Again, have a blast tonight, people. This is what a night. Thank you so much.
Soulful, sultry, steely. Best describes our next performer. She's a female artist of the year nominee tonight, and she makes bad look good. Give it up for Michela Sheedy.
Gunslinger, the bell ringing, I'm looking for a pretty little ring for my finger. I make that look good. I got two horns where my halo should be. You better look twice, boy, I'm something to see. Oh, baby, I make that look good. I should've come with a warning sign around my neck, a lesson that I guarantee you won't forget. Almost making me feel sorry for you. I make bad look good. If you're raising hell when you run with a sun, every girl that I meet knows I am what they ain't. I'm not sorry. I'm a bona fide bombshell vaccine, baby. Never been accused of being a lady. Oh, baby, I'll make that look good. Yeah, yeah. Should've come with a warning sign around my neck. Listen, that I guarantee you won't forget. Almost making me feel sorry for you.
And now to present single of the year, please welcome Taylor's 52nd cousin, Christine Swift from the Cooperators.
See what I did there?
My mom works at the Cooperators. Do you know my mom?
Yeah, we saw you in Nashville last year.
Oh, she's seen us in Nashville last year. Ladies and gentlemen, Christine Swift. It's amazing how much they look alike.
We've saved a big one for our last award of the evening. Single of the Year celebrates those songs that had a significant impact in 2018. And the nominees are...
Single of the Year. Sponsored by The Cooperators.
Count me out, it's just the first round.
Don't hold back. The Dungarees. No good. Drew Gregory.
Laid back is the only player around here. We can play it by beer.
Play it by beer. Brad Saunders.
At the time, but you had to go your own way, baby. And this
this road is mine.
The Road Is Mine, Karac Hendriks.
Who's gonna love me tonight?
And Who's Gonna Love Me Tonight, Renegade Station.
And the winner is... Single of the Year, Who's Gonna Love Me Tonight, Renegade Station.
Holy hell.
This song has been a game changer for us. We want to thank the writers on Who's Gonna Love Me Tonight. We want to thank our manager, Angie Morris of Seroma Entertainment.
Our families who put up with all of our musician bullshit.
Get up here. Yeah.
Our team, Seroma Entertainment, Drew Gregory, Jordan Pollard, welcome on board.
Thank you so much. We want to thank our extended team of Scott Clements and Paula.
Danilovich.
I can't say your last name, Paula. I'm so sorry.
But she's watching tonight, and we said it.
Yes. All the way from Mexico, you guys.
And we would like to thank all of the other guys. I mean, all of you other guys that are putting music out at the highest possible quality and kicking our ass to try and make sure that it's... that what we put out is top-notch. So thank you guys very much. Johnny Gasparic, MCC Music.
Yes, Johnny, thank you so much.
Johnny, yeah, produced this song. Yes. Incredible. And special thanks to everybody that voted for us. We appreciate it from the bottom of our hearts.
Thank you so much. Thank you, radio. Thank you, fans.
Love me tonight.
Lots of people are going to love you tonight, Renegade Station. That's fantastic. Wow, what an incredible night. Before we get out of here and we get to hear our last performer, I just wanted to say that I totally forgot Lindsay L. in my speech, and I love her so much, and I apologize. Lindsay, yeah, she rocks. Incredible night. Congratulations to all the winners and nominees. A big thank you goes out to Stingray for presenting this ACMA weekend, the Sheraton Hotel Red Deer for hosting us, Jamboree for charity for making the online streaming possible, and again, all of our sponsors, you know none of this is possible without you. Come on board with more money next year. We're going to make it bigger every year we possibly can. And thank you so much for having me tonight. Honestly, bottom of my heart, I think I found a whole new career. If country music doesn't work out, I'm having so much fun. Thank you so much. We have one final performance for you. This veteran musician is a 3-time nominee tonight and always leaves an audience wanting more. Great way to end it. Thank you for having us. Thank you for having me. Thank you to sponsors. Give it up for Karac Hendriks.
It was our 14th summer back in 93. I'd never been in love before until you looked at me. I had my members only jacket. You rocked those acid wash jeans. Holding hands and making plans down at the Dairy Queen. That summer's all we had. Didn't know it at the time. But you had to go your own way, baby. And this road is mine. Set of wheels, full tank of gas, cruising these back roads, jumping on the dash. mixtape in the stereo, Charlie Major on full blast. Never thought that day was gonna be our last, but I know you're here with me, if only in my mind. But you had your own path to take, my friend, and this road is mine. This road is mine. This road is mine. Whoa, 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 whoa. We all have a journey we need to take. We all have choices that we need to make. Someday I'll see you further down the line, but until we meet again, this road is mine. This road is mine. When I think about my life, it's like a movie scene. And that member's only jacket went with those acid wash jeans. And that mixtape still on the floor of my first car. And I think of you and what we shared when I look at the stars. But only God knows when we run out of time. But until that day comes around, this road is mine. This road is mine.